Hello and welcome to Meet the Boss TV. In this program, is it time to show your payroll a little more love? Payroll is one of the most visible of all business processes. Everybody from the CEO down has a vested interest in whether or not their wages are paid correctly and on time. Mistakes get noticed. So what are the major challenges with managing today's payroll function, particularly in large global organisations? I caught up with Marco Martin, Global VP for Sales and International Services at Ceridian, to ask that very question.
Obviously, cost savings is a major part of any corporation. And when you look at global payroll and the consolidated, centralized global payroll solution we provide, you generally can find a very strong business case to support cost savings. But believe it or not, what is just as important and what I see with clients in a global payroll model is just understanding the cost. Most companies who are having the challenges with global payroll just don't know what's happening at the country level and don't have a good understanding of the actual payroll cost. Another challenge is control, right? So control is extremely important in the global payroll model. And when you have a decentralized global payroll environment with multiple solutions at the country level, this becomes a huge challenge, control and visibility of that data. The other one would be compliance, right? So compliance is extremely important. And if you think of compliance in the US, in the UK, Canada, you know, it's not a difficult task. You know, regulations are well documented. They're well communicated, and the changes are almost within a schedule. So you can develop solutions and manage that compliance very accurately. Now, it's when you go to a global solution that really tends to present the challenges, because each country has its own regulation, has some countries may have great documentation, some have none. And then from a timing of those regulatory changes, they're inconsistent. So compliance is a huge issue in a global payroll model. And then I'd say the last thing is technology. You know, technology is definitely an enabler, and it's important to have a strong cloud-based technology solution like Ceridian's Dayforce that can bring all of the data together globally and present a single solution, give you visibility and data analytics.
Payroll is often taken for granted. It's viewed as maybe not much more than a commodity in many companies today. Is there an opportunity for global payroll to play more of a strategic role in company decision making?
Absolutely. And you know, if global payroll is not something that a company is using strategically, they're missing an opportunity, right? Especially with global companies and the global market, there's a tremendous amount of growth. And global companies, they really need to be nimble, they need to be flexible, they need to be able to respond quickly. And having the right global partner, global payroll partner, you need to be able to stand up and get into markets very quickly, and the right global payroll partner will do that. So absolutely, they're going to create a lot of strategic value.
What benefits have you seen from the companies that you've worked with in terms of those that movement towards strategic decision making?
If you don't have access to the data, or if you don't know that data is accurate and don't have it in a timely fashion, you know, it creates a lot of difficulties in making strategic decisions. You know, how can you justify entering into a new country, a new market, if you can't really determine what the cost would be, what employee headcounts you have today in order to build out the right business case? So that's just an example, but yeah, and in addition to that, you really have to look at your workforce and how important it is to deliver a consistent, high-quality service model. And so that's extremely important in a decentralized, disparate payroll solution that many companies have today.
Now, in common with every other function in the business right now, payroll is expected to be more cost-effective while delivering better quality. Essentially, it needs to do more with less. The complication is obviously, as you touched upon earlier, the need to meet contradictory regulatory compliance requirements, and there's that low tolerance for error. So how can global payroll departments successfully meet these conflicting demands?
Well, I think the first thing is understand that they're not really conflicting. They should be complementary, right? So if you think of it this way, if you're coming from a disparate, a decentralized, multiple solutions in multiple countries, and you're going to a partner who's going to bring all of that together in a single solution, a single technology environment, you drive a tremendous amount of efficiencies and savings. So an example would be self-service. So, you know, we would deploy a cloud-based solution across the globe that would deploy self-service to the users, to the employees, to the managers, that would drive more efficiency, that would drive self-dependency, that would reduce your resource need to support a lot of those functions, right? So in that model, you may actually even pay more per bill from a payroll partner, but ultimately the efficiency, the technology, the services they deliver should drive a cost saving. So that's just one example. The other example is compliance, right? You know, I talked earlier about how complex compliance can be, and it's absolutely, you know, a requirement. You have to be compliant. You know, with the right global partner, you know, we would assume responsibility for compliance. So there's a tremendous amount of savings there, because not only could you have penalties for non-compliance, you could be dealing with employee litigation for non-compliance. And then in each country, if you went to court in each country, you need attorneys for that jurisdiction. It's a snowball that you absolutely have to have the right solution to make all of those things complementary.
You mentioned technology earlier on. So how should technology be deployed? And what model should companies be looking at in order to run an effective global payroll organization?
Yeah, you know, that's a question I get all the time. And generally, you know, I see customers go into the global payroll concept with technology. And the reason why is, if you think, you know, in North America and in the UK, you can deploy ERP and SaaS, software as a service based models, very efficiently, right? So you've got very, very controlled compliance regulations. You've got tremendous amount of efficiencies across the states within the US that, you know, there's consistency through there. You can really maintain and manage an ERP successfully. But it's when you get to the global payroll model that the challenges really tend to present themselves. So think of it this way. If you were to take an ERP solution and say, I want to deploy this across the globe, you would have to deploy that ERP payroll solution in each country. So say you have 10 countries. Some you have 100 employees, some you have 1,000, some you might have 3, right? You would have to deploy a unique ERP instance for each of those countries. That means separate hardware, separate software, separate infrastructure, programmers, developers, and then you even have the compliance team. So the cost model immediately gets turned upside down. So the right solution there, I believe, is leveraging a partner that can, one, deploy a single global payroll service model. So although you've got 10 countries, it's the same model, but we're going to deploy local expertise in each of those countries so that to ensure we're compliant, to ensure we're meeting the cultural needs of that employee population, and even the native languages, and then layer that with technology, a cloud-based solution like Dayforce, that will bring all of the data to one single application that will give you robust data analytics, that will give you self-service capabilities, and a lot of different functionality that's available through that type of technology. So in that model, the customer really doesn't have to deploy any technology. It becomes a SaaS solution, cloud-based, by the service provider.
What kind of success have your clients seen in this area with deploying these type of solutions?
You know, we just recently signed a customer, I think over 5,000 employees, large real estate company, that they're going from 20 disparate payroll solutions in multiple countries to just one Ceridian payroll solution. So you can imagine how strong that business case is, how impressive it is to deliver a single service model across that organization, and there's significant cost savings there. I know about a month ago, I was meeting with a medical testing company that they've agreed to move forward with us in deploying Dayforce cloud-based solution globally that is going to eliminate close to $1 million of planned technology investment that they would have had if we couldn't deliver this SaaS-based Dayforce solution.
Are there any developments that you're particularly excited about at the moment?
Global companies are really looking at the business less about a North America solution, a solution in Latin America, a solution in Asia Pac, as a global solution. And they're tearing down the borders and saying, we absolutely need to have the same level of visibility and service in a country in Europe, in Asia, in Latin America, as we would in North America. So those are things that I'm really seeing corporations embracing, and the market is just really exploding with the need to.